Hey guys, this is Mats Abraham and welcome back to my channel. If it's your first time in my channel, I make medical related videos and pharmacy videos. So if you're into those types of videos, then if you haven't subscribed yet to my channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. For this video, I will be talking about the oral Revalida. And I will actually be doing two parts for this video. The first part would be the general tips that I want to give. And the part two would be maybe sharing a bit of my experience and also a Q&A. If you have any questions for me, even after watching this video, then don't forget to just comment down below your questions so I could answer it in my next video. So if you want to find out my personal tips for this oral Revalida, then please keep watching. And it goes a little something like, would be the sources or the references. So for the emergencies, I use the following resources. First would be the DAPOY notes. So I find this personally helpful kasi it's mostly complete talaga and it's very comprehensive. And kaya rin siya tinawag na road to meritissimus kasi nandun din yung mga dapat na kailangan mong malaman to answer the side questions just in case. Another reference would be the JMFV. So what I like naman about this reference is that kung DAPOY is complete and very comprehensive, JMFV naman is very concise. Third reference would be the Tintinalis. So ito yung parang pinaka-reference kasi pag emergencies kasi it's really a book of emergencies. Fourth would be up-to-date. So up-to-date is useful in a sense na kaya nga sinabing up-to-date, diba? So more or less updated siya talaga. And it's very CPG-based. Pero itong up-to-date kasi medyo mahaba siya talaga and kukunin mo lang kung ano yung kailangan mo. Fifth would be AMBOS. So I find AMBOS very helpful both for the emergencies and clinicals and even for the written Revalida nga eh. Kasi kinompress na yung mga important na kailangan matandaan talaga. And it gives you mnemonics, tables. And the last reference for the emergencies that I advise you to use would be clinical practice guidelines. So parang yung up-to-date din. Pero itong CPG, kasi you have to assess per topic, per emergency, kung ano ba yung CPG na best gamitin, kung ano yung pinaka-current, kung ano yung society na usually talagang basis. And yung seventh pa pala na reference natin would be the merit is a must. So this was made by my classmate before, so si Dervin. Sobrang comprehensive niya and very complete. But at that point, I was more or less able to make na my personal script. Kaya hindi ko siya super na-utilize. But it is really a good reference to study kasi nga, complete siya. Tapos parang kinumbine niya na yung iba-ibang references into one. Now you might be overwhelmed. Sobrang daming references, emergencies pa lang to ah. Ang advice ko dito is to know yourself first and foremost. Kasi kunyari, kung ayaw mo na-memorize lahat, you can just choose a references na more or less maikli, like yung JMFV tsaka yung AMBOS. Now, personally, ano yung ginawa ko? I used index cards or maybe you could use, kung gusto mo talagang typewritten, that would be okay. Basta, make your own script. And then, you would try to assess kung alin ba dun yung best information na kailangan mo lang i-include sa personal script mo. So, you have to assess it per topic. Kailangan i-individualize mo siya kung paano mo siya gusto sabihin kapag nirecite mo na. Anyway, I will expound more on that later. So, for the references naman for the clinicals, I advise you to use CPGs and journals up to date. Previous notes are our best chances for the oral Revalida. The OPD reviewers in the past, and also, of course, the prescribed textbooks. Basically, magiging difference kasi nung Revalida na to, dun sa kunyari mga usual na SGD natin dati, mga case discussion, is that you have to make it evidence-based, dapat holistic yung approach mo. So, kunyari, kaya ako ina-advise magmamed ng CPGs, ng journals, para if you use these as your resources, then when it comes to answering questions, clinical, sa panelists mo, you can cite those references. And bukod sa mas maganda pakinggan ganyan sa tenga nila, it would make you more reliable, tsaka plus points talaga yun. The second part would be in terms of making your schedule. And the schedule for the topics should be dependent on your current rotation. That is because the most important thing here in your preparation would be integration. You have to integrate it to your actual hospital experience, sa conferences nyo, dun sa inaaral mo for that day. And that way, mas maalala mo siya, mas nagme-make sense siya, tsaka mas marami kang masasabi. So I'm flashing to you here a sample schedule. So in first columns, you can see yan yung number of days left. Ito din yung parang pressure mo sa sarili mo para you can remind yourself na hala, ang lapit na pala. Next columns would be the date. And then for the rest of the column, so it starts with your rotation. So lalagay mo dun kung ano yung rotation mo for that day and your status. So if for instance, pumapasok kayo sa hospital, so place there kung pre-duty or from para dun mo rin medyo mag-gauge kung ano yung amount ng maaaral mo. And then for the next column, ito namang column na to would be for the emergency. So you could list here the specific emergency that you want to study or you want to memorize for that day. The next column would be the subject. But of course, syempre from the time of the preparation to the actual revalida, pwedeng hindi mo naman ma-rotatean lahat. So, ikaw na bahala kung kailan mo isisingit yung mga ibang subjects or topics. The next column naman would be for the clinical. So, that would be the clinical that I want to study na medyo connected dun sa rotation ko and sa emergencies. And of course, another column para dun sa mga iba ko pang kailangan gawin. So, in terms of your schedule, paano ba aaralin or magpe-prepare for the emergencies? You have to write your own script for the emergencies. Kung gaano karami, this depends on you. Pero ang goal ko noon was about 1 to 2 per day depending on how busy I was nung clerkship. But I highly advise you to write kasi mas nakatulong siya and mas maalala mo siya and it's really personalized. One more way by which you can prepare for this is by recording. So ito, I find this helpful as an auditory learner. Bukod sa paggawa mo ng script, pagsusulat mo, pagbabasa mo, you can also record yourself reciting after you made the script. And so you can just listen to the recording sometimes pag nasa CR ka, pag naliligo ka, or pag tinatamad ka lang mag-aral or magbasa. Again, the more senses, the better. So before you prepare for your emergencies, ang unang-una syempre na dapat magawin is to choose which emergencies you actually want to make a script for. So right here, you can see a table. And special thanks to Dr. Dale Imbag for sharing this to us, wherein he already plotted here the statistics in terms of the percent chances that you could get at least 1, 2, or 3 out of the 3 sa mga numbers na idadraw mo for the emergencies. So for me, what I did was I studied 30 emergencies. Because basing it on the statistics, sa tatlo na numbers na pipiliin mo, there would be a 97.68% chance na merong isa kang mabubunot na naaral mo dun sa 30. So I would tell you more about what actually happened dun sa actual oral revalid ako, wherein wala sa lahat ng nabunot ko yung mga inaral ko. So I will tell you about my experience in the part 2 video. Now aside from these statistics, what are the other factors that you should consider in choosing ano ba yung mga emergencies na dapat piliin or i-memorize? One main factor there would be your panelists. So as much as possible, try to pick those emergencies na hindi specialties ng panelists mo. Another advice for your emergencies is to have between 2 to 4 cycles para i-memorize siya. So personally ako, hindi ko talaga nadaanan lahat ng 30 na pinili ko na memorize ko sila talaga. But for those few that I really chose to memorize by heart, trinay ko talaga na madaanan sila na 4 times. Now let's move on to the clinicals. Basically, advice ko lang sa clinicals in terms of making your schedule is to study well your current rotations. So kung ano man yung maging conferences nyo or yung ma-assign or ma-encounter mong patients, then those are the topics that you should master for the clinicals. And then, 1 month before your actual revalid the day, I advise you now to conduct mock interviews. So, dito, mag-history and PE ka by pair or by groups. Na sense na mayroong mag-act as clerk, mayroong mag-act as patient, tapos may tatlong panelists. Kasi trust me, there is no better way to prepare for the clinicals other than to actually practice doing it. And another advice when it comes to making your schedule for the whole preparation is not to adjust the whole schedule if you're not able to follow it on certain days. So, in short, iwasan mo mag-domino effects. Always put there days for rest or days to accomplish the topics that you're not able to finish. Part 3 would now be about the overall priorities. So you first and foremost have to set your goals, which is to ace the oral revalida. Bakit to very very important? Because this is your time to shine. So kunyari, nung first to third year, hindi mo nagawa yung best mo or hindi mo nahabol yung gusto mong GWA na i-meet or para sa Latin honors, then this is your chance. Kasi starting actually sa batch namin, inaba na yung grading system, included na talaga yung oral revalida grade sa buong GWA. Kunyari, hindi ka naman running for Latin honors, then at least this could give you meritissimus benemeritus. Your next priority is to find ways by which you could have maximal retention. So, hanapin mo na lahat ng ways na sa dami-dami na kailangan i-memorize at aralin, kailangan mag-study smart ka talaga. Maximal retention meaning, it's better na hindi mo talaga sobrang i-master or i-memorize word for word, para mas naalala mo siya. Another priority would be your time for prayer. Kasi nobody really knows kung anong magbubunot mo sa emergencies. Nobody really knows kung ano yung clinical case na mabigay sa'yo. So you could only do your best and you could only pray for the best. Another thing that you should keep in mind in preparing for your oral revalida is to avoid burnout, especially when you are already having your face-to-face duties. Edi agahan mo mag-aral, you try to avoid cramming, you make a schedule as I showed earlier, and of course, leave time for self-care. Kahit na alam natin na sobrang important na itong oral revalida, please don't forget to take care of yourselves. Now, for the emergencies, what should be your priorities? So, personally, I said, diba, I chose to study 30, but more or less, I just mastered half of that, which was 15. So, ito yung memorize ko lang by heart come the actual revalida day. Next, you have to choose what you are confident in. So, kung kunyari, nung MPPRC nyo, nagkaroon pa ng report ng ACS, tapos sobrang minaster mo siya back then, if that's your personal favorite, edi okay din na yun yung isa sa mga piliin mo for your emergencies. Next, you have to practice drawing the numbers. So, dito, pwede kasing kahit gamitin mo na lang yung randomizer. Initially, baka kailangan mo pa ng guide or hindi mo pa super memorize. But eventually, mas magiging spontaneous na siya talaga. So, aside from practicing by drawing the numbers, you should also think of all the possible side questions. So, it's better na when you answer their questions, you try to relate it to the actual setting and experience mo as a clerk, or you can also cite references. Next would be your priorities for the clinical. So what's most important here for this part is that you know the usual OPD cases. Next would be to make a standard script or flow. Para regardless of the department na mabunot mo, meron ka parang i-discuss something outside that. Kasi the word that I have been using here is always the word holistic. Kasi nga dito, you try to show your panelists that you are being a good doctor by looking at every problem and trying to manage every problem. So dito standard script mo, here is how I advise you to do it. So first of all, syempre, you would be doing the usual general data, the chief complaint, the HPI, and then you'd be doing the rest of the history, like the family history, past medical, the PE. Formulate your initial impression. So even before you discuss your differential diagnosis, you could already state to them, based on the history and physical examination alone, my initial impression as of this point is, so sasabihin mo na. So after mentioning that, you could say, so what are the other conditions that we should consider or that we should rule out before we rule in allergic rhinitis? So parang ganun. You could mention most especially epidemiologic data. And of course, other than that, ang maging focus mo talaga would be the history and PE as your basis. My next tip for the clinicals is to practice or at least study on how to do the history and physical exam based on the chief complaint. So, dapat masana yung utak mo na mag-isip ng lahat ng tatanungin mo, lahat ng i-elicit mo sa history and PE based on that alone. So, what I did was, for some subjects, I actually made this flow na parang kung itong chief complaint, ito yung magiging questions mo to come up with these differential diagnosis. And another bonus tip, pagdating naman ng PEDIA, meron tayong tinatawag na approach to diagnosis. So, this is found in the blue book. Especially if you have a PEDIA sa panel, they would really appreciate that kasi they always ask us to use that when it comes to formulating our differentials. My next tip is to always add a PrevMed part. So this would include yung mga pinggang Pinoy, yung mga age-appropriate preventive plans. And it is very, very important when you discuss your clinicals na you really try to make it practical. You try to make it realistic. You may mention mo din sa panelist mo on how you would instruct the patient. So things like that. Basta gusto kasi dito is hindi tayo playing pretend. Talagang ipa-feel mo sa panelists na nilalagay mo yung situation mo dun sa kapag kaharap mo na talaga yung pasyente mo. Kung anong gagawin mo, paano mo siya i-manage, paano mo siya kakausapin. Another thing sa clinicals is to master the cases related to your panelist specialties. Why? Because it is your chance to impress them. So, syempre, dahil specialties nila yun, they expect na kung yun yung mabunad mo, marami silang pwedeng tanong sa'yo. And dapat masagot mo yun. So, you have to dig deeper to impress them. However, one of the things that you should pray for talaga is sana hindi ka makabunad ng specialty ng panelist mo. Why? Because that could either make you or it could break you. Now, before I end this video, I would just like to give some of my general tips. First, you have to study smart, in a sense na you have to know when or when not to utilize a specific reference. Kasi baka may info overload ka na, tas hindi ka lang din matapos. Next, you have to have the right amount of pressure. It's bad na sobrang lax ka, pero it's bad din naman na sobrang pressured ka. The most important thing dito sa oral revalida, kaya nga ito oral revalida, hindi ito written revalida. So, itong oral revalida, ang pinaka-important is practice. Be it emergencies or clinicals, practice talaga. Then one more thing dito sa oral revalida, when it comes to answering the questions of your panelists, don't panic. Talagang very important dito na you try to compose yourself. Tapos kung di mo alam, don't show it na lang. Tapos you try to sound like you know what you're saying. Syempre, confidence is key dito sa oral revalida. Pero hindi naman natin gusto maging overconfident or that we sound too confident. But you have to be firm with your answers. Hindi ka dapat mag-bluff. If you don't know the answer, Just say what you know. Kunyari, may tanong sa'yo, tapos di mo alam yung sagot. Doctor, I am not really sure about this, but what I do know is that at least they know na you're trying and that at least they know na meron ka namang alam, hindi lang sakto dun sa tanong nila. And so, overall, ano ba dapat yung mindset kapag nag-oral revalida ka na? Say what you think a Thomasian doctor would say. We try to be compassionate, competent, and committed, and show them that you deserve not just a good grade, but you deserve this MD. So you just have to be very sincere to them in answering their questions, and just simply give it your all. You really just have to have faith in yourself, and of course, have faith in God. Now, please do remember that your preparation for the oral revalida does not just start after the written revalida. It should have started siguro the whole med school or even more so the whole clerkship. Kasi the more patients that you encounter, you have to think of that as more learnings. More learnings that would help you better in your revalida, but more so, more learnings would make you a better doctor. And dito kasi sa revalida na to, you have to accept that you would really have to make a lot of sacrifices along the way. I know it is normal na we tend to compare yourself with others, yung pacing ng aral nila, yung pacing mo, but you just have to focus on yourself and huwag kang masyado ma-intimidate or ma-pressure dun sa schedule ng iba or sa pacing ng iba. So that is it for this video and I hope that you find this helpful. If you have some questions that you want to ask, you could either comment here below or just message me on Instagram or Facebook and I will be answering them in my part 2 video. Thank you very much again guys for watching, especially kung tinapos mo until the end of the video. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe to my channel and especially turn that notif bell on so that you would know kapag na-post ko na yung part 2 video.